This is Demeo, the game for the people who live from the 90s who's played Heroes Quest. If you've ever played Heroes Quest, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. But this is the augmented reality version that they've implemented, and now you can play in your own games room, even complete with, look at this, complete with a prop. And if you don't like it in this position, you can move it somewhere
else. It really
feels like I own a big board game. And I can put my hands here, I can rest.
I hope you brought your galoshes.
Now, if you have big enough space, like my dining table, we can make it even bigger. So we started off small, and now we're gonna go bigger. Look at this! Now if I want to, I'm gonna walk around my entire table. Oh, this looks so amazing. As it's bigger, it just looks so much more immersive.
This is Drich Forest.
I'm gonna walk around this table.
Where the druids of Drich reside.
A chair.
And they do not really welcome outsiders with tea and biscuits, if you know what I mean.
Collect some gold.
It's the monster's turn.
I stand prepared.
Let's see how big I can actually get this. So we had a small size before at the games room, and then we had this size, and now I'm just gonna stretch it as, oh my gosh, I'm gonna stretch it as big as I can. This is a floor affair. I don't think I have enough room. Oh, ouch, bashed into my laundry box. This is as big as it gets and is ridiculously huge. I am almost a piece in this entire game. Oh boy, this is huge. Let's move around the entire dungeon.
Okay, monsters.
Let's try a fireball on some rats. Oh, it's not my turn. Oh boy.
I have readied my spells.
Fireball incoming. Whoa, look at this die.
Makator, Sabo, Makator, foul creature.
You can go to a hero's hangout. You can enter a room code with your friends after if you've created one. So you can either do a public room or a private room. And this particular room is in VR, so you won't be seeing your own space. But when you do go to get here, you can choose one of these books. And then you can place it on the playing area and then it'll start your game. If you're bored, you can go play some stuff. This is like the original Gauntlet, if you've ever played Gauntlet. And I think this is what the game... Oh, it's not the good potion. It even got the right sound effects. I think I can pick up one of these bows. Oh, I can. Ooh, 10 points. Oh, I can shoot a cup. Oh. Oh, a camera. Oh, why did I look through it? I'm so dumb. Oh, wow, I can upload to Discord. Let's join a game and play with some random people. Every time you run one of these dungeons, there will always be a boss with a key. And you want to be able to take that creature out.
Comes with a bit of a key.
And carry the key all the way to a door somewhere. After you've finished each round, you can go into the shop and start buying equipment, which is kind of cool. I feel like maybe I should buy a barricade.
A fine choice.
And here's my barricade that I bought last time.
Unleash
you look
pain!
At your hands as well, on your right hand, you can see whose turn it is. Wondering when to hear all the turn orders. That's the monster's turn. And over here are the spells or the abilities that you have each turn. Oh no, sadly.
Taste my blood.
I died just at the door with one of these creatures at my feet. Wow, this guy.
Strike.
He's so detailed. Oh, you want to go outside? Okay, here you go.